as soon as AI can human better than a human can, it's tough. Like right now, the knowledge-based skills are going to go first, which is reverse of what people thought. They expected it to be blue collar. Like if you had asked people 2 years ago, what's AI going to fix first? They're going to be like, well, all the low-skill jobs, all the labor, that's going to get replaced first. And then it'll be the slightly lower-skilled white-collar jobs. And then the higher-skilled white-collar jobs like programmers and things like that. And then finally, maybe the creatives. But it's been the exact opposite of that. It started with the most creative things like making images and paintings and pictures and essays and words. Like most of human communication in a creative venue, like it can do that first. And robotics is already there in terms of being able to do better than what a human can. It just hasn't become cost efficient. But we know on any time horizon that technology becomes more efficient over time. And when that AI brain meets this robot body, it can now do what humans can do in the real world. And so like, where do humans go? That's fundamentally the issue. They have a 4.5 year UBI study that's being undertaken by OpenAI because they, I'm pretty sure, know what's going to happen. Even if there are jobs that like some humans can do, most humans can't. And so like ChatGPT writes better than like 60% of Americans.
In 15 seconds as well.
It's right. And that's today. The question is what ChatGPT 100 can do. Maybe writes better than all humans. Because there's something called the drift, which is right now AI is learning from humans, right? It's learning from the stuff we do and it's mimicking that. But in a future iteration, it will learn from itself. It'll be AI learning from AI. And then at that point, it starts to drift away from what we know to what is purely AI generated. I'm very worried about what will happen for the vast majority of people. You know, I'm a competitive person. We absolutely have embraced AI within our company, and that's because we don't have a choice. Elon has far more clout than I do, and he lobbied with the government for years to get AI regulated, and they refused to hear him out. And the thing is, even if the US regulated it, China won't. It's super tough. And you know, like, what about education and things in schools? Like, you know, they're like, no school technology can use ChatGPT. It's like, yeah, the kids don't have phones. Yeah, so it has really profound implications, and I think humans are really bad at predicting things. That's what I can say. Like the fact that AI 2 years ago, people would have said blue collar jobs, and it's literally the last thing that's being replaced, just shows you how bad we are predicting. My predictions are weary at best. I hope it ushers in a golden era for humanity. I hope more than anything. We do nuclear fusion and we cure all diseases and we can reverse aging. Like, I hope we can figure all that stuff out. But if you can get your logo designed in 5 seconds and get 10 different versions, who gets fired?
Alternate versions, alternate colors in a millisecond. Yeah.
In the short term, and I said this in the video, the short term, the people who are going to do quality assurance on the stuff that ChatGPT spits out will be the opportunity. They'll actually have an outsized opportunity. So like, if you know how to write code, then what happens is now you can write 10 times the code. So the execution has been delegated, but you still have to think, is you validate that the code is correct or is good or does the job that it needs to. If I were to ask you to write code, I don't know how to read code. So it doesn't matter that it can write code for me because I don't know how to judge it. So I still need a human to do that. And that human can now check 10 times as much code or 100 times as much code, which means the value of an expert increases in the short term. Long term, once the AI can check itself and can do it better than a human can, it can check millions of lines of code.
You know, we have essentially what, like Petri dish babies now. I can choose the eye color, the hair color, what gender they're going to be. Yeah. You know, some people can do certain tasks, and with Neuralink, maybe everyone can have these attributes to them. You know, there are some people with photographic memory. Now, what if everyone has access to photographic memory and everyone becomes superhumans? What do you think of the future race if everyone's just perfect?
At the end of the day, you know, survival of the fittest means the survival of the most adaptable. You know, if you go from bio flesh that can get diseased, it can get hurt, it ages, it decays, right? And you have a robot that's, you know, 100 times as strong, can upgrade itself. You can, like, no one gets old because you literally can just upgrade yourself as you're going. I know we're bordering into, you know, science fiction here, but point is, in our lifetimes, some of this stuff is possible, you know? And if AI can start innovating on its own, then there was a futurist who said, like, AI will be the last invention humanity ever needs to make. Because then it will make all innovations after that faster, better, stronger than we can. And if the future race is a merge between humans and AI and cyborg, then that would be interesting. The question is why they would need us.
A lot of people, you always hear about outsource, delegate, delegate. When do you think people need to get to the point where they are doing it? Like, what are things that people shouldn't let go of and things that people should let go of immediately that generally they hold on too long?
So again, I won't say should and shouldn'ts, but I would say if you're optimizing towards making the most money, then you have to trade up in higher leverage activities. So it's so leverage is just defined as the difference between inputs and outputs in a system. So if I do this, then I get this output. And so the leverage is the discrepancy between that. So if I have a 1-to-1 ratio, I have low leverage. If I have a 1-to-10 ratio, I have higher leverage, right? And so when we are leveling up as entrepreneurs, we need to trade out the things that we get 1 to 2 on and trade in things that we get 1 to 20 on. And you just keep trading the whole way up and you just keep going. And that's the kind of unending infinite game of business.
What do you think is like the number one thing that people shouldn't delegate? Like when you start a company, right? Yeah. You have a passion behind it. There's still something like, what's the point you get to when you're just like, you just collect a check and you don't even like live in the world of that business anymore. Like, do you think everyone should get to that? Or like even with acquisition.com or some of your stuff, like, do you think there would be a point where you're like, I don't literally do anything. I just own it. Yeah. I don't need to look at it ever. Like, do you lose the interest and the passion for it when it gets to that point though?
Well, if you get to that point, then you're probably inherently disinterested. So if you like, so again, I won't do shoulds. If you like doing something, then by all means do it. If you're optimizing for how much money can I make, then it's theoretically, if you can get someone to do the same thing that you're doing and do it for less than 100% of your equity, then you trade up. And if you get lots of people to do that, then you make more money. So the idea is to actually is solve for zero. So if you solve for no time, no energy, then you have infinite leverage on that thing. And so if you have lots of zeros, then you have all your time and you have checks that are coming in. In terms of like life fulfillment, that's a totally different question. But if you have no commitments and you have cash flow that's going in, then if you want to, you could pursue the next business, you know, if that's what you were interested in, or if you like painting or whatever, you know what I mean? So what are the things that people shouldn't outsource? Nothing. You should be able to, you know, you can outsource whatever you want. I think it's just what goals do you have? If you love painting and your whole business is painting, as soon as you hire painters, you're no longer painting anymore. Is that what you wanted?
Yeah.
Some people, yes. Some people, no. Because the difference is, if a painter wants to make money painting, that is different than somebody wanting to start a painting business. And so one is a business career, the other is a technician career. And a lot of people, and that's actually a really big one, a lot of people who are technicians love the craft and hate the business. And they need to decide whether they want to be business people or they want to be technicians. And I don't think there's a right or wrong answer. They just need to decide for themselves and then stop their expectations about having both. Because the businessman wishes he could paint all day. The painter wishes he could make the money of the businessman. I think people can, if they want to make more money, then you optimize for the vehicle that will make you the most money. And then you do that. The whole passion piece teases at the psychology of humans. Because if you're just looking at first principles of like what has to happen, like build the business that has the highest leverage, that has the highest total addressable market, that has the highest potential gross profit per customer, and do that. That's what you would need to do if you wanted to make the most money. As soon as you add in the psychology of humans, it's like, when do you get tired of this? When do you lose interest in it? And so the big thing for me, at least, is that I love business. And so as long as I'm doing business, I'm good. And so the nature of the business doesn't matter as much. And I would say a lot of entrepreneurs are that way. And so the big decision is, do I want to be a technician or do I want to be an entrepreneur? And they are very different paths. And I just don't, it's very difficult to have both.